In the previous lesson, we saw how we can import a text file into Excel and tidy up that text file using text functions. And in this lesson, we're going to do exactly the same thing, but we're going to use Power Query to tidy the dataset instead. Power Query, if you've never used it before, is a really useful feature of Excel. It allows us to take large datasets, transform them, tidy them up, and then import them back into Excel. And a lot of people find Power Query a lot easier to use than they do text functions. So let's take a look at how it works. We're going to start by re-importing the text file that we did in the last session. So we're going to jump up to the Data tab, and in the Get and Transform Data group, we're going to select From Text / CSV. Now this is going to open up the pane, so let's select our file and click on Import. And Excel is going to go away and create a connection to Power Query, and we can see all of our data imported in. And this is the first 200 rows of our dataset. Now at the bottom, we have a few buttons. We have Load, we have Transform Data, and we have Cancel. If we were to click on Load, it's just going to load it into the Excel spreadsheet, or we can click on Transform Data to open the Power Query window. And from here, this is where we can tidy up this dataset. Now you can see that we have quite a few issues going on with this dataset. We've got things like blank rows. We have inconsistent case in the product column and also some weird spacing issues. I can also see that many of the columns aren't formatted with the correct number formatting. So we're going to tidy up and fix all of these errors in Power Query. Now notice we have our ribbons running across the top, so it takes on the look and feel of Excel, and on here we have all of the commands that we need in order to tidy our data. We can see our query listed on the left hand side, that's our sales data table, and on the right hand side we have query settings, which shows the name of our data table, and then underneath we have applied steps. Now this keeps a log of everything that we're doing in Power Query. And the cool thing about this is that if we make a change to our data set and we want to backtrack out of that change, we can simply click on the cross next to the action in the Applied Steps pane. And that will undo that change and take us back a step. So it's like an undo button, effectively. Now let's start out by tidying up this data set. And the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to remove the blank rows. You can see here we have null values in our blank rows. And we want to get rid of them all in one go. Now, this is really simple using Power Query. We don't have to select them individually and delete them manually. We can simply go up to the Home tab, and then in the Reduce Rows group, we can click the Remove Rows button. And then notice we have a few options. And one of the options that we have in this menu is Remove Blank Rows. So let's select this. And like magic, it's going to remove all of those blanks from my dataset. The next thing I'm going to do is remove duplicates from my dataset. So this is checking for exact duplicates. And you can see here it's removed the majority of my dataset because I was clicked in the country column. Now I'm going to backtrack by clicking the cross and applied steps. And I'm going to select all of the columns prior to removing the duplicates. Now to select all columns, we just need to select the first one, scroll to the end of our data, hold down Shift and select the last column. Now with all of my columns selected, I can then do Remove Duplicates, and it's going to remove the records where every column is an exact duplicate. The next thing we need to deal with is some of the casing issues that we have in the product column. You can see here that some of the values are in uppercase, some are in lowercase, and some are in proper case where the first letter is capitalized. Now that's how I want everything to look. I want the first letter capitalized and everything else in lowercase. Now we can do this using Power Query. So all we need to do is select the column, go up to the Transform ribbon, and then underneath the Format drop-down, we can choose Capitalize Each Word. And this is effectively like doing a proper in Excel. If we go back to Format, we can then do Trim, and that will trim any erroneous spaces. And like magic, that column is now tidy. So what else do we need to do here? Well, if we take a look across our dataset, one thing you'll notice is that where we have our headings, Next to it, we have a little icon which denotes the data type for that column. So this is similar to number formatting in Excel. So it's always worth going through and checking each column to make sure that Power Query has applied the correct data type. It gets it right most of the time, but sometimes it doesn't. So we're going to start with country. Now this contains text, and I can see that, yes, that one is correct. We have text assigned. You can see the little ABC icon just there. If we move across to the next column, this is also text, which is fine. So we're going to click units sold, and this is going to be a whole number. Manufacturing price is going to be currency. And if we scroll across, sales price is currency. That's fine. Gross sales, well, that's going to be currency as well. Now, discounts. If I scroll down, I can see that I do have some discounts at the bottom, but for the first few cells, there is actually nothing in there. So if I change this to currency, I'm actually going to get an error in the cells where there are no values, but that's okay at this stage. Let's move across to sales. We're going to change that to currency. The same thing for COGS, that's also going to be currency. Scroll across a bit further. We have profit, that also needs to be currency. And then we have date, so let's change that. And then the final two columns, month name and year, these are both set to text, and that is fine. Now also notice at the end here, I have a blank column. So I'm going to right click and I'm going to say remove because we don't need that. Now this data set is looking pretty good. I think I'm ready to load it into Excel. Now, once your dataset is clean and you want to put it back into your Excel spreadsheet, all you need to do is go to the Home tab, and in the first group, the Close group, we have Close and Load. So we're going to say Close and Load. That's going to minimize Power Query down, create a connection to the data, and load it into an Excel table in your workbook. And one thing you'll notice is that even though we apply data types to many of these columns, such as the currency data type, they don't always carry across. Data types are actually different to number formatting. Data types really tell Excel what type of data is in the column in the background. So you might have to go in and reapply currency formatting once you have it back in Excel. So I'm going to select the unit sold column. Let's just apply comma formatting to that. And then I'm going to select these columns and let's make those accounting format. And you can carry on going through your data set, applying the correct formatting. Once you've done that, we are ready to analyze our data in a pivot table or a pivot chart.
If you're not a subscriber, click down below to subscribe so you get notified about similar videos we upload. To see the full course that this video came from, click over there. And click over there to see more videos from Simon Says It.